Hello, this is Mrs. McCullough. In the previous lessons, we've been talking about how readers have different voices. We've talked so far about how they have two different voices. They have the reading voice that actually tells you what the text says, but you also have the thinking voice, and that's the one that tells you what the text means. But there is another voice. You see, readers actually have three voices. The third one is called the distracting voice. And so we're going to add to our anchor chart today, and I want to teach you about that third voice, distracting voice. You see, the distracting voice here, it has a little bit of a jagged edge around it, kind of like an alarm is going off. And that's what happens when your distracting voice has started to talk to you. It's distracting you away from the text. It's making you think of other things that don't pertain to what you're reading or you're viewing or you're looking at. And so when we notice that our distracting voice has started to talk to us about things other than what we're trying to read, we've got to stop it. We've got to stop it, and we've got to go back to reread to re-engage the thinking voice. Okay, so let me show you what I mean. You see, as I look at my chart here, then I notice that we've got three different colors happening too. We've got the green reading voice with the speech bubble. Green means go, and it kind of reminds me of a stoplight. Green means go in the stoplight. Let's look at a stoplight here for a minute. Green means go. Now, not too fast, okay? I don't want you reading super fast. I want you to read at an appropriate speed. But green means go. You read the text. And then yellow, what does that mean? It means that we slow down. We pause. We have thoughts during the reading. Not just at the end. You slow down and you have thoughts as you read a sentence or a paragraph or a page. But then you see this other one, distracting voice, that's red. And let's look at our stoplight. What does it mean when you have red at a stoplight? Of course, that means stop. And that's what you have to do. You see, when your distracting voice has kicked in, you're thinking, but it's not about the text that you're reading or you're viewing. And so you've got to stop yourself. You've got to actually go back to reread. You've got to re-engage that reading voice, reread the previous sentence or paragraph or page, and now really get your thinking voice to tune in again. You see, that's why we have the stop. That's what we have to do. We have to stop and reread, and then it's like our thinking voice has to apologize to reading voice and say, oh, I'm sorry. Would you mind going back to reread a sentence or two? Because I kind of forgot. I wasn't able to focus on what we were reading because distracting voice had butted in. And so I've got to stop him, make him quit, and I'm going to be thinking about the text again. Okay, so let's talk about this for a minute because I think you actually do this. I think you do this a lot. Like when you're viewing something on a tablet. Many of you I know watch videos on YouTube and things like that. And when you're watching the action happening, sometimes you're not paying attention to what's really here. Sometimes your brain thinks about other things like, I wonder what we're having for dinner tonight. Oh, I really want to go outside. Oh, why did that girl bring her glue stick to the lesson, right? Sometimes that's what happens. We start thinking about other things. And so what we can do is we can reverse. We tap on the side and it takes us back a little bit. It takes us back to the previous couple of screens so that then we can re-engage and we can think about it. So that's the type of thing that you're going to do when you're reading. You've got to reverse. You've got to back up. You've got to reread. So let's try this. I have a book here called A Bad Case of Stripes. And maybe you've heard it before. You've read it or your teacher has read it to you. And so I want to show you and model what I would do if my distracting voice had taken over, okay? So Camilla Cream loves lima beans, but she never ate them. All of her friends hated lima beans, and she wanted to fit in. Now, wait a minute. You know what? I was reading the words. That reading voice had been working, but my thinking voice wasn't. You know what I was thinking about instead? I was thinking about lima beans. I used to have to sit at the table all night long because I would not eat my lima beans. My mom would make me sit there while she did the dishes and she cleaned up. And you know what? I still don't like lima beans. Was I thinking about Camilla? No, I was reading, but my distracting voice had kicked in and it was taking over. Okay, so then thinking voice comes slamming back up to the front and says, whoa, wait a minute. Reading voice, would you mind going back to reread? I've got to be engaged. I've got to think about this. So I go back up to the previous sentence, back up to the previous paragraph sometimes, and I have to reread and really now engage that thinking voice. Camilla Cream loved lima beans, but she never ate them. All of her friends hated lima beans, and she wanted to fit in. Camilla was worried about what other people thought of her. Oh, poor girl, she loves something, but she doesn't even want to eat them because she's afraid that her friends will make fun of her. She wants her friends to like her. Now see, that is a thinking voice thought. That's connected to the text. Let's see what happens when I keep going. Today, she was fretting even more than usual. It was the first day of school, and she couldn't decide what to wear. There were so many people to impress. She tried on 42 outfits, but none seemed quite right. She put on a pretty red dress and looked in the mirror. Then she screamed. Wait a minute. Screamed. Sometimes when I hit a certain point, then my thinking voice is like, what? What's going on? What has she been doing? Because you see, distracting voice had taken over and I was thinking about Olivia. Olivia at school, she got the best clothes. I know, I'm so jealous of her clothes. I really wish I had 42 dresses. I bet she has 42 outfits too. I bet Olivia does. I wonder what she's gonna wear on the first day. You know what? That was distracting voice. So I've gotta stop myself. I've got to ask the reading voice, do you mind to reread? I've gotta go back up. Can I just go to the beginning of that sentence? Then she screamed. No, I can't because I don't remember what any of this other stuff was about. Can I go back to the beginning of that sentence? She put on a pretty red dress and looked in the mirror. Can I go back to the beginning of that sentence? She tried on 42 outfits. Oh, yeah, that's where it was. 42 outfits. I started thinking about Olivia. She tried on 42 outfits, but none seemed quite right. She put on a pretty red dress and looked in the mirror. Then she screamed. I wonder why she screamed. Oh, now see, that is a thinking voice thought. I'm wondering about Camilla and why she screamed. Okay, so now I want to try this out a little bit, but I would like for you to help me. And so I was wondering if you could listen to my thoughts. And if you could help me determine, is it a thinking voice thought or is it a distracting voice thought? I want you to be the one to decide. And so if it's a thinking voice thought or a distracting voice thought, and then I want you to help remind me what I'm supposed to do if it's a distracting voice thought, okay? So here's the next page. I'll be the reading voice. I'll tell you what my thoughts are. Her mother ran into the room and she screamed too. Oh my heavens, she cried. You look completely covered with stripes. That was certainly true. Camilla was striped from head to toe. She looked like a rainbow. Aw, rainbows. I love rainbows. I love to draw rainbows. I think I'm going to get my crayons so I can draw some rainbows. Wait a minute. Was that a thinking voice thought connected to the text? Or was that a distracting voice thought that took me away from the text? You're right, distracting voice. And it took me so far away, I almost got up to get my crayons. Oh, what am I supposed to do when it's a distracting voice thought? Go back to reread? Okay, so I'm gonna go back to reread. Let's see. Do I remember this? This was certainly true. Camilla was striped from head to toe. Yeah, I remember that. She looked like a rainbow. Oh, yeah, I remember that. That's what got me off. Okay, so now I'm going to keep reading. Mrs. Cream felt Camilla's forehead. Do you feel all right? She asked. I feel fine, Camilla answered. But just look at me. You get back in bed this instant, her mother ordered. You're not going to school today. Aw, I'd love to go outside today. It's so beautiful out. Blue sky and the sunshine. I bet it's warm. Yeah, there's a window right in front of me. Oh man, if I could go outside, I'd walk the dog. Oh, wait a minute. What kind of thought was that? Was that a thinking voice thought connected to the text? Or was that a distracting voice thought that took me away from the text? I think you're right. I think that was distracting voice. And so what am I supposed to do when it's a distracting voice? Oh, I'm supposed to stop and reread, re-engage my reading voice, and make sure that my thinking voice is focused. Okay, so now I'll go back to reread. Let's see, do I remember this part? Nope. Okay, do I remember this part? Yeah, okay, start there. I feel fine, Camilla answered, but just look at me. You get back in bed this instant, her mother ordered. You're not going to school today. Oh, man. Her mom's going to make her stay home on the first day of school? Is that a thinking voice thought or is that a distracting voice thought? That's a thinking voice thought. So what should I do? Keep going? All right, that's what I'm going to do. Camilla was relieved. She didn't want to miss the first day of school, but she was afraid of what the other kids would say. And she had no idea what to wear with those crazy stripes. Now, guys, I think you're really getting the hang of this. You're so good at that thinking voice that then you can quickly notice when my distracting voice was taking me away from the text. So here's what I'd like for you to do. If you are in Mrs. McCullough's class, I would like for you to continue this story. Oh, and let me show you where you can get the book. I'm going to actually go out to YouTube. So ask an adult if you can go out to YouTube and type in Storyline Online in the search part. There, you'll find all kinds of picture books that you can use to practice this, to pay attention to your thinking voice thoughts you're having. And if you have some distracting voice thoughts, stop yourself. Go back. Rewind, reverse on the video so that you can re-engage that thinking voice. Okay, so which one do you want? You want the one that says A Bad Case of Stripes, read by Sean Astin. Okay, he looks like this. He's a movie star. These are all books read by movie stars, so he might look familiar to you. But he'll read the whole text to you. And so you can follow along. And just like how I was reading the book, then I want you to engage your thinking voice. And I want you to try to see if your thinking voice is having thoughts about the text or if your distracting voice is taking you away from the text. And if your distracting voice is taking you away, I want you to remember, what are you supposed to do? Stop yourself. Go back. Reread. Re-engage that reading voice and see if your thinking voice has any thoughts about the text. And let me let you in on a little secret. You know what? All readers have all three voices. Even people who you think are really good readers, like me, your teacher, your parents, maybe a teenager that you know, they all have a distracting voice. It's just when somebody has been a reader for a long time and they've practiced it a lot, they know the trick. They know to stop themselves. They know to go back to reread of the previous parts and then re-engage that thinking voice. So if I were your teacher, I would have you go on to YouTube and I would have you listen to it and see if your distracting voice is taking over, and then have you reverse and then re-engage the thinking voice. But your teacher might have an even better idea to get you to practice reading voice, distracting voice.